Hi, 同学好，这是孟老师。So, 今天 we're going to talk about the basic Chinese sentence structure, which is very important. Please watch this video before you attempt to do your paparazzi project. Okay, so very simply, the Chinese sentence structure start with time. And let's say you have different time information in there, then you're going to go from the most general to the most specific. So a general time frame will beyear, months, and then a more specific time will be days of the week or the day of the month, and more specifically what time it is. So you're going to list the time from the most general to the most specific, and then you're going to say who, and finally, this always comes last, which is the activity or the verb in the sentence. So, for example, 上月，对不起，上年十月十六日星期五晚上九点半。So all those time from the most general, we start with the year, and then the day of the week, which is Friday, and then at night, 我, it's the person, and the activity is 睡觉。Another example, 2012年二月二十五号早上六点妈妈吃早饭。And of course, again, 吃早饭 is the verb and it will go last. All right, let's look at some of the practice questions together. So, number one, I play video games on Wednesday afternoon. Okay, so in the English sentence, the thing that you see last is the time. But remember with Chinese, we're going to put that in the very front. So what is Wednesday afternoon? I hear someone said,星期三下午, and you're absolutely right. So the sentence is going to start with 星期三下午. What comes next? The person, who is that? Is 我. And what's the activity? Play video game, 打电玩. So the whole sentence will be 星期三下午我打电玩. Number two, last Tuesday, 8:30 at night, I watch TV.So this sentence is kind of put in the Chinese grammar pattern for you already. So it sounds like this. 上星期二晚上八点三十分我看电视。Number three. Next Sunday morning, I plan to go shopping with my family. What should go last is go shopping. That's right, because that's the verb. What comes first? The time.So what's the most general time is next Sunday and then morning. Who are the people? My family and I. So the sentence will be 下星期天早上我打算和家人 activity last 去逛街。Again, the sentence will be, Nerds and Beyond, when did I subscribe to that? All right, forget that. Sorry about that. It'll be 下星期天早上我打算和家人去逛街。Number four, Susie watched the ball game at 5:30 on Monday. We're going to switch the sentence around and say the time first, which is 星期一五点半 Susie看球赛。Again, 星期一五点半 Susie 看球赛。All right, and number five and six, you can do on your own. Make a sentence based on the picture. Include a person or people, time, and activity. And you can go ahead and fill it in for questions 1 to 4 as well with character and pinyin. Now, when I say character and pinyin, what I mean is if we learn how to write it in character already, you will do it in character. If we haven't learned how to write it in character, you will write that word in pinyin. You don't have to write both in character and pinyin. Okay? R-I-D. Bye. 再见喽。